day. I'm Mr. Munsur M. Balmes, your science facilitator today. We will demonstrate the understanding of the relationship of electricity and magnetism in electric motors and generators. Let us explore the science world.
Answer is south. Okay, next, who wants to volunteer? Yes, Diane. So you're going to get a mystery box and then just pack it to this magnet. Okay, anyone here, Diane? Okay, it will tell us the room sa sao. So, ano kaya yung ating polarity? What is the polarity of the box? Sao, very good. Okay, next, who wants to volunteer? Yes, Akia. So get a mystery box and then suspend it to this magnet. What happened, Akia? It will tell us, okay. So what do you think is the polarity of this box? North. Okay, very good, North. Okay, very good. That is the major concept of the world's fastest train, which is located at, which can be found at? Yes, SR. Very good, at Shanghai, China. So I'm going to show to you a video from a maglev, a magnetic levitation, from Japan. Hindi sa China, okay? So everyone, let us watch the video. Explains the rule of the magnet. What is the rule of the magnet?
Opposite poles attract. Right poles repel.
Very good. And based on this picture, how does the magnetic levitation works? Anyone? Okay, Eunice.
Sir, for me, like poles repel and push the train upward, and then opposite poles attract and pull the train forward.
Wow, very good. Class?
Yes.
Is it possible to create a magnetic car?
Yes.
I have the opinion, Mrs. Shore. Okay. Why yes and why no? Okay, bakit kaya yes at bakit kaya no? Ano ba yung advantage ng pagkakaroon ng magnetic car at disadvantage na magnetic car? Anyone? Yes.
For me, sir, I think it can save our ecosystem from the gas emissions and also can produce some.
Okay, sige, okay lang yan
naman. Nakapag, ano po tayo, nakapag-save po tayo ng sa gas consumption.
Very good, no? Sabihin, makakapag-save tayo ng gas or fossil fuel at the same time ay mababawasan yung pag-iinit natin ng mga carbon dioxide or greenhouse gases. Nice! What else? Ano ang kinagandahan ng pagkakaroon ng magnetic car? Ay, yung disadvantage na kaya? Ano kaya ang disadvantage? Kapag yes, why are you?
Sir, kapag po kasi ng ano tayo, like yung force po ng magnet na aatak po yung mga metal na nasa paligid natin, baka po makakasama po yun sa magnet.
Very good, no? Okay, ibig sabihin ay pwede ma-attract ng magnetic coil yung mga ferromagnetic materials na nasa paligid natin. Halimbawa, no, nagluluto ka, tapos dumaan, biglang humigil. Okay? Halimbawa, nagbabay ka, tapos may dumalaman din, para biglang ka lang, biglang humigil. So that is the disadvantage of having a magnetic car. Ano pa? Yes, Cyrus?
For me, sir, it will be able because the object in the picture has a zero net force. So one of the important parts here is that if it has a zero net force, there will also be a zero accident. these objects, if it starts with zero velocity, it will only remain as a velocity. So it will not move, and so it will not work.
Very good! Okay, very good, Cyrus, no? These three objects, if they have the same forces, there will be no acceleration. If there's no acceleration, then there will be no speed, the car will not move. So, anong gagawin natin para mag-move yung car? Ano kayong mangyayari? Anyone? Yes, Cesar.
If we can try making the magnet bigger to maybe be able to make it able to pull the car, but if the magnet gets bigger and heavier than the car, then the car will be pulled up.
Yung car natin, ang mangyayari, i-move natin yung magnet. Ang mangyayari, pag sobrang bigat yung magnet, ano mangyayari sa car? Aangat siya. Okay. So, imposible na magkaroon tayo ng magnetic car. Okay. Just like this concept of the cartoon Looney Tunes. Napanood niyo na ba ang Looney Tunes?
Yes!
Okay, paruari natin yung concept ng magnet sa Looney Tunes. Ayan, may maluwag yung goma. Okay. So, So at least, no, nakailaw natin. Okay, ulitin mo, driver. Para makita nila na umiilaw talaga siya. Ayun! Okay. Maluwag talaga yung ating goma. Okay, thank you so much, driver. Napakasasal natin si driver. So based on our activity, we have four major parts of the DC generator. We have the field magnet, the armature, the slip rings, and brushes. So the magnet produces magnetic flux in generator, and this is called the field magnet. And the direction of the magnetic flux is from north to south pole. And we have also, this is an armature, is a coil at which insulated conducting wire is wound over the laminated self-iron coil, and the slip rings, okay, are attached to the armature coil. And then yung direction din yun ng pag-ikot ay same lang sa armature. So armature coil rotates continuously using mechanical energy. Simultaneously, armature coil deflects the magnetic flux lines, and the EMF is generated in the coil, and this continuous motion of the armature coil helps to keep a constant current to flow. Class?
Yes!
We will have our experiment time. Okay, so? Yes, so that you will better understand our lesson for today. So, class?
Yes.
Mirror me. Today.
Today. I will investigate.
The properties of electromagnets.
The properties of electromagnets.
And value.
And value.
The importance and applications.
The importance and applications.
Of electromagnets.
Of electromagnets
in everyday application.
In everyday application.
Class?
Yes.
Class?
Yes, yes.
Go to respective group now. Move silently or quietly. Please carry your chair. So we have group one. I hope that you already have your group leader, tama ba, nag-group na tayo dati. And then yung group leader ninyo ang kukuha ng mga materials dito sa harap. So from group 1, group 2, group 3, group 4. Okay, leaders, please get your materials here. Then we have group 2. Then we have group 3. Battery. Nabigyan ko ba ng battery in group 2? Okay. And then group 3. Aliha, okay. So, happy na na. Group 3, group 4. Ayan. Group 4. Group 5. And then group 6. So class, for our experiment, you have 10 minutes. Okay? Ating class, mag-ingat kayo sa paggamit ng ating materials, especially yung ating nail sa ating experiment. Mag-ingat kayo, baka kayo ay matuso o kaya mayroong makadisgrasya yung pointed part ng ating nail. Okay ba?
Yes!
Okay, let's start our science experiment. meters, kumuha kayo dito ng additional battery.
Thank you.
tinanong tayo sa ano, bakit kaya?
Because they have the same energy.
Very good. The same energy, but I'm the same. What? The same?
Well, not the same.
Okay, polarity. They have this. They are the same. They are the same electrons. And then if we have two protons, ano mangyayari, class? Sabay-sabay?
They will repel.
Okay, they will repel. Kasi nga pareha sila?
Pareha
sa positive. And then if we have one electron, and one proton, what will happen?
They
will attract each other. Okay, very good. Ngayon, what if merong dumaan na neutron? Ang neutron ay zero ang kanyang charge. Ano kaya ang mangyayari kapag merong dumaan na neutron sa ating electron at saka proton? What will happen? Yes, Cesar?
Sir, it will just pass by, sir.
Very good, no? Tama. Ibig sabihin, dadaan lang siya na straight line kasi nga, zero yung kanyang charge. Okay. Next, what will happen naman kapag mayroong dumaan na proton? What do you think will happen? Yes, Ira. Okay, very good, no? I-attract nung electron yung proton, pero i-repel ng proton yung proton. Okay. Next naman, paano pag may dumaan ng electron? Ano mangyayari? Yes, Sharish? Okay, very good, no? Yung electron, it will attract the proton, and then yung electron ay mag-repel. Okay, guys. What happened, or what is your observation from your experimentation? Anyone? Ah, dito muna tayo. Sa group 1. Ano nangyari doon sa experimentation? Volunteer. Yes, Christian?
Ang una po namin ginawa ko ay yung bako po, tinaskat po ng saliya at okay na po. And then, binami po namin yung cover po, doon sa bako ng paikot po, yung wala po
Okay, walang space. Okay, so inikot ninyo yung couple doon sa nail na walang space. Okay, very good. Tapos, ano nangyari?
And then, yung
wire
ko.
Okay, dahil nikot it. Okay, kinunod nyo
sa? Sa copper
po. Okay, copper at?
Ano po?
Battery. Okay, ano yung source natin sa yung experiment?
Yung battery.
Okay, yung?
Battery.
Tapos, ano nangyari, Christian?
Nung pinutok po namin yung dulo po ng nail sa may bakal po na ring, nagbunikit po siya, nag-attract po.
Okay, very good. Lahat ba naging successful yung experiment?
Yes!
Okay, gumikit ba lahat yung mga ferromagnetic materials na ginamit niyo?
Yes!
Okay. So, nung binigyan ko kayo ng additional battery, anong nangyari? Okay. Yes, group 2. Tama, no? Noong dinagdagan natin ng battery yung inyong experiment na electromagnet, mas lalong lumakas yung magnet. Okay, very good. And what other observation? O ano pa yung mga nakita ninyo sa ating experiment? Anyone? Okay, si Ira. Yes, from the North Pole to South Pole. Okay, very good. And it will become a big?
Large scale.
Okay, large scale of magnet. Okay, very good. Thank you. Next time, Ira. So, ibig sabihin,
doon sa inyong experiment, meron, nung nilook ninyo, yung inyong copper, doon sa loob, may mga electrons. And then yung electrons sa iyon ay nag-produce ng magnetic field. And then yung maliliit na electrons sa iyon, pag tinagsama-sama natin, magkakaroon ng napakalaking magnetic field. Okay, tapos yung kanyang direction ay from north pole to south pole, kaya nakapag-create tayo ng napakalaking magnet. That is why, if we combine electricity and magnetism, anong mabubuo nating word? Okay, very good. Electricity and magnetism, if we will combine, we will create electromagnetism. Okay, class, our science word for today is electromagnetism. Okay. Nasabi natin kanina yung rule natin, no? What will happen? If I will cut the magnet. So, pag hinati ko siya, anong mapoproduce natin?
Two
magnets. Very good. So, dito yung ating north, and dito yung ating south. So, ano ang polarity nito?
South!
Eto?
North!
Okay, very good. So, ang mundo daw ay isang napakalaking magnet. Tama naman. So, ang mundo nga daw ay isang malaking magnet, and this electromagnetism is one of the four fundamental forces. So, we have the gravitational, weak nuclear, strong nuclear, and the electromagnet. Asan ba yung concentration ng force ng magnet? So, ito yung ating ion filings. Ayan, may iron dito sa loob. And then, lalagyan natin yung magnet. Okay. Makita ninyo, ano ang nangyari? Dumikit yung mga ion. Saan kaya yung concentration niya? Sa? Kaya niya saan yung concentration niya? Sa? Sa dulo-dulo. Sa north at saka sa? South pole. Very good. Okay, sabi natin, no, ang Earth ay isang napakalaking magnet. Tinatawag natin ito, geodynamo. Okay, so, Earth's poles attain positive and negative charges. So, what is the importance of this geodynamo? Yes, Cesar. You want to explain from the bottom? Okay.
Earth's magnetic field basically acts like a shield against the sun's harmful UV rays that would otherwise make the planet uninhabitable and dangerous for us.
Wow! Electromagnetism. Meron sa mga paligid natin na mayroong magnet at syempre sinasaksak natin, no? Kaya meron pong electromagnetism. Ano kayong mga bagay na yun? Especially halimbawa sa math. What is the importance of electromagnetism in math? Anyone? Yes, okay. Victor.
Sir, in math, engineers design electromagnets, which are basic parts of motors. Electromagnetic motors are a big part of everyday life, as well as industries and factories. We may not even realize that we interact with electromagnets on a daily basis as we use a wide variety of motors.
Okay.
Our life is here.
Hi, very good. So, yung mga engineers, ginagamit nila yung electromagnetism as the electromotors. What else? Yes, how about in TLE? Ano sa TLE, pag nagkapasi kayo sa TLE, ano yung mga gamit pag ginagamit ninyo na mayroong magnet or electromagnetism? Anyone from the class?
Sir,
Ate Cedric.
In TLA ICT, we use computers and printers. In TLA cookery, dressmaking, and home economics, we use refrigerator, washing machines, clothes dryer, vacuum cleaner, garbage disposal, and other materials that uses magnets.
Ah, very good. Yes, Cyrus?
Doorbells.
Ano pa? Yes? Computer. Ano pa?
Yes.
Speakers. Okay, no? Marami pang iba. Okay, especially in mate. Doon sa mate, ano naman yung mga materials na ginagamit niyo sa mate na mayroong magnet? Yes, Eunice? Okay, sync player, music, and speaker also. So, makikita ninyo, no, meron akong speaker dito. At yung speaker natin ay meron magnet. Okay? So, yan. Kaya gumagana yung ating mga speakers. Because of our science word for today?
Electromagnetism.
How about in AP? Ano kayong importance ng electromagnetism in AP or Araling Panlipunan? Anyone? Yes, Jasmine.
In my own understanding, in AP, there are many choices of words, sea creatures, submarines, and ship exploration around the world. Please, based on electromagnetism, because they use it to navigate around the world.
Very good, because of the navigation, kayo, alam natin kung saan yung north, south, east, west, and so on. Very good, Jesse. Now, what is the most important application of electromagnetism? Ano kaya yung importance ng electromagnetism? Makikita natin ito sa ospital. Ano kaya yung tawag doon? Okay, Cesar, anong tawag kaya doon?
MRI,
very good. Okay, no, ano ibig sabihin ng MRI?
Magnetic resonance imagery.
Okay, Alin? Yes, Alin? Ito yung MRI, no, yun yung itsura niya. Yes, ano ibig sabihin ng MRI, Alin?
MRI, or magnetic resonance imaging, is a medical imaging technique used in radiology to form pictures of the anatomy and the physiological processes of the body.
Okay, very good. You know what? Now we have MRI, lalong-lalong nito sa ating mga pasyente. Tulad ng mga bata na mayroong cancer, yung mga tao na mayroong tumor. Alam niyo, habang ginagawa ko itong PowerPoint presentation nito, naaalala ko yung aking nanay na mayroong tumor. So, nagkaroon siya ng tumor sa leeg, and then namatay siya dahil hindi siya nakahinga. So, imagine na yung kahalagahan ng MRI. Kaya naniniwala ko na kayo ay magiging scientist in the future gaya ng mga scientist na favorite ninyo. At makakadiscover ng MRI na portable. Kung saan yung mga tao na nasa bundok ay hindi na sila pupunta sa mga malalayong ospital, kundi yung MRI mobile mismo ang pupunta para sa kanila. Tama ba?
Yes, sir!
Tama ba na magiging scientist kayo in the future?
Yes, sir!
Gaya na inyong favorite scientist, naniniwala din ako na isa sa inyo or lahat kayo ay magiging scientist at nakaka-discover ng mga gamot o mga materials na mayroong electromagnetism na nakaka-contribute sa ating society. Okay, palakpakan natin ang lahat. Okay, class, we will have our formative assessment for today. So, this formative assessment is based from PISA. Okay, PISA questions yung ating ginamit para kayo ay maging ready na kapag mag-take ng PISA exam. So everyone, go back to your respective group quietly, and we will have a group quiz B. Okay, ng nasa respective group na kayo. Ngayon, bibigyan ko kayo ng marker at ng whiteboard para sa ating group listing. Of course, isusulat nyo dito yung inyong mga tamang sagot. And then, iskola natin kung sino pinakamataas iskola, siya ang mananalo. Are you ready?
Yes!
Okay, readers, please get your whiteboard here and then marker. Group 1. Group 2. 3. 4. 5. And 6. Class?
Yes!
Are you ready?
Yes!
Okay, so magkakaroon tayo na group is B. So we have group 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 items and total. Class?
Yes!
Are you ready?
Yes!
Here's the question number 1. Okay, time's up. Please raise your answer. And the correct answer is letter B. Okay, so nakuha lahat. Group 1, group 2, group 3, 4, 5, and 6. Next question number 2. Time's up, please raise your answer. And the correct answer is letter C.
Yay!
Okay, nakuha lahat. Very good. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Next, question number 3. Raise your answer, and the correct answer is letter B. Okay, very good. So group 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Next question, question number 4. Time's up. Please raise your answer. And the correct answer is letter D. Yeah! Very good. Okay, so group 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay. Last question. Titignan natin kasi yung pinakamagaling. Question number 5. Time's up. Please raise your answer. And the correct answer is letter C. Very good. And it's a for group 1, you got 5 points. Group 2, got 9 points. Okay, congratulations, guys. Palakpakan natin ang ating mga readers. Ibabalik na nila yung ating mga report. And then please go back to your proper place. Quiet. Tachycast, you have your assignment, working, okay, your extended activity or extended activity, making an interview. So being an environmentalist who promotes energy efficiency and helping climate change, as the owner of the junk shop, and during an interview, how they dispose of the gathered magnets and copper. So 1 minute yung gagawin yung video, dito papasok yung values sa ESP, no? Papaano yung pagtatapon ng tamang, disposal ng mga magnet and copper. So 1 minute na video interview sa mga junk shop owner. Naintindihan ba?
Yes, sir!
Okay, thank you so much. Please, everybody, stand. That video, thank you, and see you tomorrow.
Thank you, and